Hello everyone, I want to do a video today on doing a horn using the Helix 3D inside of ZBrush. Now this is a little different method that I was just kind of thinking about how to, you know, get a quicker horn. And what sometimes we'll find, and I'll show you where I'll also forget to use this. Because if you go in here and if you append this in there and you go to this Helix, it's already made into a mesh, so it won't do the extra parameters that you need. So when you go and initialize, you only get these options. Now unless there's a different way of getting in there, you'll have to go through the subtool on the main menu. So we'll delete this. And I'll go inside of this button. And when you go down to the bottom, if you go to initialize now, you'll see we got new parameters. And this is where I want to show you how to get like a quick horn out of this. Because all this profile, the thickness, the radius, offset, can get you something pretty interesting. You can change your coverage down to where you can get a spirally looking horn. And if we really need to, we can probably import that head inside of here. I'll go back and turn on the subtool. Needs to be selected. We'll go back into here. We can append it. And we'll grab that head. So now we got this head. And we will move this to position where we want it to kind of give it a placement. And that's probably where we'll have the horn. It's kind of big right there. For now, we're gonna scale this head inside of here. Is it on symmetry? Off. We'll snap this to the center. Not that. Center this head. We'll scale him up. Oh, he's just a little bit bigger than the horns. And we can push this back. And we'll select this. And now we can start editing this profile. You can adjust your coverage to where it kind of comes down, and we'll get something about like that. And we can adjust him some more. Push his head up. And now you kind of got something going on. And you can see the initialize goes back to the default, the cube, the sphere, and the grid. We'll select this, and it changes it. We can adjust a lot of parameters inside of here. Is pretty cool. So if you go to the profile and you look at this, you can actually adjust the way the curvature, almost like a little bit extra details in there. On the thickness, you actually can lower the thickness at the end. So now we got a point, and we can actually raise this back up. You got a little bit, and you can play with this right here if you want to kind of give it more of a ram look, some rams. You can thicken it up just a little bit and play with it to get it just right. Go ahead and adjust this head. Looking for alternate ways to get this in there, but now you can kind of see how fast you can get a horn inside of here with these parameters. The other thing we can play with is the offset. So if you want to offset this, we can actually push and pull a different direction of that. We can actually play with this a little bit, get it in there, and get it closer to him to where it's more of a unique look than your average. You need to get rid of this, click and drag, and it goes away. And that's pretty close right there. So we can actually adjust this, the count. If I turn on the poly count, you can see how many polygons are in there and the divide. So I could put about 50, half of that, and now you got something to sculpt with and actually adjust your mesh with. We can push him over a little bit. What I notice, if you try to do it the other way, if you try to move this, say for instance you want to move this around, and you adjust a parameter, it snaps back to the original origin. So that didn't work. I had tried it earlier, it didn't work too good, so I'm more or less moving the head now to get the look I need. But now you can see in here, you can actually get some interesting looks. We'll get the profiles going. You can push this up and down. The other thing is that you can actually add more points. This is what I like. You can kind of get more of a that unique look of a horn. And then you can do the same over here. We can actually push and pull different points up and down. Just like that. So now you got some actually interesting features on here. And it looks pretty quick. Fairly workable. I think this could work. Let's see what else we can get. A little more interest on both sides right there. And we can actually raise this up to be a little bit more. Now you got more features. And then after that, you can go back in and sculpt it after you make it a polymesh 3D. This is just a quick rundown on what you can do with this. Let's go up here. We'll create a polymesh 3D out of that. We'll create another subtool. We'll go to the original character and we can append that tool back into here. And you can see all the details already in place. You can drag this up. We can scale it down and put it right in there. And now we can mirror and weld. And you got an interesting look. Now you got this. The other thing I'd like to show in here on your Helix, if you want to taper this down to be a little bit more pointy, let's go back to this right here. This radius. This radius is actually controlling. You'll see this goes up and then down. So up and down. And that'll actually crunch it. So if you need a little bit more squatty horn, or if you need to push it up a little bit more, I can show you what I'll do right here. So you can see where it deforms in there. Now you can get some interesting looks with that. But I like that you can mess with this where you get like just the right look. You want to squish it down to where it does a little twist. And there you go. Quick horns inside of ZBrush using the Helix 3D. It's just a short video. And I wanted to show this. Thanks for watching.